I'm in on. And today is my last day here in this really beautiful resort in Egypt. And here is my place to paint. Today I do something with the flowers. I paint for you these flowers with this watercolor, aqua color, and maybe with this Lura color pencil. Yeah? And this is beautiful flowers from me. Now I begin, and I don't draw before. I begin just to draw with my aqua color. It's a quick painting. Here are my flowers. You see this beautiful yellow, orange, and some pink. My watercolor, and I begin as always with a yellow one, as you know. Second one, it's first one, you see more left here, down is second one. Here, third one. Orange now. To make some shadow and maybe some contrast to yellow. Not all, just only part. The same as here. Middle. And here some orange, but not all. And here, just only medium. And then I take ochre, you see? Again, yellow, maybe another kind of yellow. Here. Make a little bit stronger because I need a color. Yes, then I need yellow maybe here. For this big white one. So, a little bit more yellow here, like this. And then I make maybe some pink. One red and second, I don't have more. If you have a bigger one from this aqua color, you can use different, but I don't have a lot of. I have only just two, dark and very brightly red, but it's okay, it's enough for me. Here. It's here is right. You see, I have a contrast. Maybe here it's more light and here is a more contrast. And again, I take some violet, I think a little bit to get more pink because another red, it's warm red, more orange. So, and now another red, you see? So, and now I need a contrast, you see? I have done with warm color, and now I take this turquoise, it's a green, blue, dark a little bit, and I begin to do something between. Because I need a contrast between these leaves, flower leaves, and maybe this green, you see, I need this contrast. Without this contrast, I don't have a nice picture. And for the night picture, I need this, some another color, some dark colors. Black is always at least. but now you see I used this color. Then I need something maybe brown like this for the middle of flowers, maybe here also. And I think it's now time a little bit orange maybe here. And black, at least black. And what I'm doing with the black here in the middle, some points, some highlights here, between maybe, some, not all. A little bit too strong, press too strong, because, I lost some piece. Did you see? So it's a black here. And now I'm going right. And I think I'm finished here for the drawing, and now I need I will take water as always with a brush and water and paint it finish. Okay, let it paint. You see, it's my picture. I have a water here, and at first some water drops here, and as you know, I begin with the yellow. Let some white places, it's very important. Here, 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 pink, here I have to concentrate because you see I have some here a little bit problem because it's my sketchbook and it's not stretched as always. Watercolor paper is always it's always stretched. It's not stretched. In this case I have, so you see, not in the line, and I have to take care with the moving from the water from the picture, because I paint just only with the water, as you see, and not more. And very important in the picture that you let some white places. Only so, in this case, picture can be nice. Also here. So here it's a little bit too much orange. I can do something. The same as here, you see, I move and make some water points. And you see I get here in this area some nice watercolor effects, and maybe here. And you see small brush stroke, really small. and let it with the water and let it. And I think now I'm finished with the picture. I have to wait till it dry. Now the picture is dry, as you see. It's really very high quality, these crayons, because they don't lose the colors. Because if you are paint with watercolor, you have to know that all colors go down about 50%. Okay, now you can let it. You can say, okay, you love it and it's enough for you. But you can use also my Laura, as you know, watercolor crayons. And I begin here is always with yellow color. I begin here a little bit, and here in the darkness. Yeah, here it's a dark side, here is this and brightness side. And in the dark side, I do some a little bit yellow as highlights, as point, as contrast. You don't need a lot of, but a little bit make your picture more colorful, more brightly. Next one, it's blue. It's the same in darkness at first and always in white paper. If you use this color pencils here, for example, I use it here. No, it's okay, it goes. Normally it's not really good, but here it goes. I don't know why, but so. And now I go in the brightly side, and I can use also some orange, just only for this side. So here, and I think it's enough now. You can see that it's really flowers, and you have watercolor effects, and you have here a graphic effects. And now I take a black one, just only for last touch. You see, my stroke is always, it's not new for you. You know, stronger and so not so strong, stronger and some points. Here's the same. And also here I begin always in the middle, but you don't need to around all middle part, just only a little bit. And here, and you see, here it's a problem to draw over these crayons, because they maybe they have some substance into them, I don't know, but it's really hard. It's much easier to draw on the paper, but it's okay. You see, I get some contrast here, always the same with this flower, some, not every leaf, not everyone, but just only some in the middle. Maybe here some a little bit. And maybe here some black lines, black strokes and black points that that you can see that it leaves. Yeah. Class, it's your one, I think. What do you think? I think I'm finished here. It's enough. It's a holiday sketch and I hope you like it. It's my last sketch and tomorrow I go back to Austria and you get completely different pictures. Not so bright, not so colorful. Maybe winter pictures. Ciao, until next time.